Hi, I'm Tom Anderson. I'd like to introduce you to the world of bucket drumming. The first thing you're going to need is, of course, a bucket. The most common that's used is a plastic 5-gallon bucket that you can buy at a paint store, hardware store, for about $5 or less. So bucket drumming isn't expensive at all. You'll notice there's a handle on the bucket. You're going to need to remove that because you don't want it rattling around when you're playing the bucket drums. Set it off to the side, and you're set to go. Turn the bucket over. You're going to be hitting the bottom of the bucket with sticks that we'll talk about next. The next thing I'd like to talk about are sticks. The least expensive way to go is to go to a hardware store and buy a dowel. A 1/2-inch dowel is about the size of a drumstick. I cut this into a section of 16 inches, and it cost me about $2 to buy that dowel. Now, dowels aren't quite as heavy as drumsticks, but they're okay. You can practice with them, and you get the same motion as drumsticks, and like I said, it isn't that costly. But if you can, go to your favorite music store and buy a pair of drumsticks. The type that I would recommend have wooden tips. The other type have plastic tips that might fly off, but with wooden tips, they'll last much longer. What's fun about drumsticks is you can click them together and make this sound. You can play air drums and not make any sound at all. Now you're ready to use these on the bucket. When you hold the drumsticks, you kind of want to hold them towards the end and loosely so that it's kind of flopping in your fingers like so. You don't need to hold it that tight, just nice and loose. You do the same thing with your left hand. It looks like that. This is called a matched grip because both hands look the same. The motion you'll be using most of the time is alternating your hands. Right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left. That way you can get more speed, and the thing that you want to make sure you're doing is doing it evenly. Probably the most common tone on a bucket is just hit the top of the bucket with the tip of the stick, like so. You want to build up your speed, and again, it's a right, left motion. Try for as even a sound as possible. Another sound you can get on the bucket is to hit the rim like this. That's called a rim shot. Really cracks, doesn't it? If I have the rim shot with my right hand, the middle of the drum with my left, it sounds like this. Another sound you can get, you have to use your foot for this. You lift up the bucket so it's at an angle like this, and you hit with the thick end of the stick. This is called the bass tone. Hear the difference? If I have the bucket on the ground, it sounds like this. Lift it up, it sounds like that. If I have the bass tone with my left hand, right hand rim shots starting with my left hand, it sounds like this. Now I'll double up the number of bass tones with my left hand, and it sounds like this. Now we have all the tones we need to play along with a song.